Hello students, we have discussed in earlier videos about the Indigo lesson, the beginning, how here Gandhiji and Rajkumar Shukla had communication. Then Gandhiji proceeded with request to the Champaranya. Then Gandhiji had a meeting with the secretary of British Landlord Association. Then here Tirur Division Commissioner reference was there, and the finally at the ending here we can understand the police superintendent, he had sent the messenger, and that messenger was taking very important thing from the Gandhiji, that is the acceptance. So Gandhiji accepted the notice to leave that Tirur Division or the Champaranya. But Gandhiji had written on that I will disobey the order. And what will happen now? Next day, you can understand, after the disobedience of that order, he has to present in the court and to give clarification about that problem. So here, in consequence, Gandhi received a summon, means the order, to appear in court the next day. All night, Gandhi remained awake, and that whole night Gandhiji was awake, and Gandhiji had planned things. So whenever any impending disaster or such type of problems will occur, you have to stay on to take out the important gist from that and to present yourself with full possibilities, whatever possibilities are there. And you can note it down, that possibilities, and you can fight. So here, all night Gandhi remained awake. He telegraphed Rajendra Prasad to come from Bihar with influential friends. So he telegraphed Rajendra Prasad. You can understand Rajendra Prasad, he was also a famous lawyer, and he would come with the influential friends from Bihar. He sent instruction to the ashram. He wired a full report to the viceroy. So viceroy at that time, he was the supreme authority. And so here Gandhiji had done important thing, that he wired a full report to the viceroy. And simultaneously here, ashram culture, the instruction to the ashram, because that system, it is also equally important, because due to that ashram culture, so many followers, we can say the devotees, followers, they were there to follow Mahatma Gandhi. So he had given that, he sent instruction to the ashram as well. Because what happened, and here Gandhiji disobeyed the order, and further what will happen, he may not get that time to give all the detailed instructions. What will happen next, I don't know. So he had wired all that information to the viceroy as well. Next, morning found the town of Motihari black with peasant. The news spread that Gandhiji, he was in problem due to the authorities. So the peasant from that area, which spontaneously, there is no call from the Gandhiji regarding this, but mouth publicity, mouth to mouth here, everybody got that news, and the poor illiterate peasant, they gathered in that area, and so many peasants would be there. So we can observe only the black with peasants, means only we can observe the heads like that, only the hairs, the blackness. So many people gathered like that here, black with peasants. They did not know Gandhi's record in South Africa. They don't know anything about, more about Mahatma Gandhi, whatever his contribution, and he fight for in the South Africa for the justice. They had mere heard that Mahatma, who wanted to help them in trouble with the authorities, that the Mahatma Gandhi, and that Mahatma Gandhi, they used to think he is the champion for them. And he was in trouble because of the authorities. They had merely heard that a Mahatma who wanted to help them was in trouble with the authorities. Their spontaneous demonstration means that, what is that demonstration? To visit that place with all their friends. So their spontaneous demonstration in thousands around a courthouse was beginning of their liberation from fear of the British. And earlier it was mentioned that only if they will file case in the court, that would not be the way. But the fear, liberation, freedom from that fear, and that is here the beginning. And here we can understand around the courthouse was beginning of their liberation from fear of the British. Now they would not have any fear about the Britishers, because they are there to support Mahatma Gandhi, and that was the spontaneous support. And this is the beginning, this beginning of the freedom. Because now they are not thinking about the British, there is no fear about the Britishers. Whatever will happen, now they are ready to face the situation. And that is what here Gandhiji was waiting for. The official felt powerless without Gandhi's cooperation. So the court officials, others, they felt powerless because so many people are there. Anything may happen. Mob doesn't have any psychology. They might do anything. So here, because of that, he helped them regulate the crowd. So Gandhiji helped them to regulate the crowd. Gandhiji convinced the crowd to don't do anything. With non-violence, we will have, or with law or with the rules, regulations, or with proper proceedings, we will go ahead. So here we can observe one important thing. He was polite and friendly. Even though there was a support from outside, that so many peasants were there, lawyers were there, but then also Gandhiji was friendly, he was polite. So this is the behavior of any great leader, that you should be polite, you should be friendly with officials, because it is their duty they are doing. So as per their duty, whatever procedure they are doing, so we have to be friendly with them. He was giving them concrete proof that their might here, hitherto dreaded and unquestioned, could be challenged by Indians. So here further, here again some more information it is provided. The government was baffled, confused. Why government was baffled? What to do now in this situation? Because so many peasants are there, and there may be now this is the situation of law and order, anything may happen. The prosecutor requested the judge to postpone the trial. And now there is a new thing we are observing, that Britishers, they used to do all their tasks according to their schedule. But now, due to this type of situation, now they have to change their proceeding, their timing, or they have to postpone the trial. Apparently, the authorities wish to consult their superiors. And at the same time, what they would do, they would consult with their superiors. Now this is the condition. We have taken the decision to take Gandhiji into the custody. And especially here, now he is there in the court. He was summoned. So Gandhiji was there. But in that courthouse, around that courthouse, so many people are there with his influential friends, lawyers. So now this is the condition of law and order. Gandhiji protested against the delay. He read a statement pleading guilty. He was involved. He told the court in conflict of duties. So here, this is also, it is given infer the meaning. So here, conflict of duties means clash or obligations or responsibilities. And what is that conflict of the duties? Here it is mentioned. On the one hand, not to set a bad example as a lawbreaker. Gandhiji here mentioning that I don't want to set the example to disobey the order as a lawbreaker. I don't want to do that. It is not my intention to do that. I am here just to give justice to the poor peasant, because landlords, they have done wrong thing. They harassed and they extorted their money. So I am here just to give justice and to investigate the issue, and after collecting the proper information, I can deliver all that information. Then next, what happened here? On the other hand, one view is this: I don't want to set such type of thing as a lawbreaker. On the other hand, to render the humanitarian or national service for which he had come. So what is this? This is my national service. I am here to give that support or to give justice to the poor peasant, and with the humanity approach, because they are also human. If they are poor, doesn't mean that we will humiliate them. We will follow untouchability with them. We will force them to do the things which we would think. So like that, it is not there. Everybody has their own rights. So nowadays, human rights, or there are so many people, they are doing that work and they are providing the justice. Means even in the prison also, the prisoner, they are also getting rights to take education, to read. Means according to their schedule, they can work. But apart from that, there is also such type of provision in the prison as well. They are also having that liberty, freedom to read, to write. So here, we can think about that. So here, humanity approach, and one more important thing, that is national service. That this is my national service work. It is not my personal work that I am here. Not for want of respect for lawful authority, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, the voice of conscience. And the inner voice, the voice of conscience, is saying from inside that whatever you are doing, it is correct. Because it is for the national service. It is for the beneficial, for the humanity, or the human beings, or the poor people. So here it is important. Then the voice of the conscience. He asked the penalty due. And now he asked for the penalty due. The magistrate announced that he would pronounce sentence after a 2-hour recess, and asked Gandhi to furnish bail for those 120 minutes. Gandhi's refused. Again here, why to give that bail of 120 minutes? So Gandhiji again refused. The judge released him without bail. And again, the authorities felt powerless due to the peasant support. Means common man's support is important. Common man can change the system. But the leader should be good. The leader should not take the power of common man. And after taking the power, he would do such type of things which would not be good for the humanity. So some politicians, they may influence in such a way that we are there to help you. And sometime that may be the double standard nature. And when they will get something from that company or the businessman, then again they will leave that question, and they may not get the satisfaction, or the people may not get the real justice with that person leadership. So here when the court reconvened, the judge said he would not deliver the judgment for several days. Meanwhile, he allowed Gandhi to remain at liberty. And now here, Gandhiji got that liberty. And this is here happened due to the very important thing here, selfless attitude, selfless intention, and with proper plan. Directly, Gandhiji would be there without his influential friends, or without discussion with the lawyers, or the influence of the means his awareness concerned with that. Directly, if he would go there, then he may not succeed. But with planning, with proper way, using his knowledge of the law, so here we can understand the best of the things here. He is now going ahead with his plan, and he would succeed, because officials, that judges, they felt powerless due to the such type of things. Then here Rajendra Prasad, Brij Kishore Babu, Maulana Muzaffar Ul-Haq, and several other prominent lawyers had arrived from Bihar. So here are some names here mentioned, prominent lawyers' names mentioned. They conferred with Gandhi, means they had a dialogue, communication with the Gandhiji. What would they do if he was sentenced to prison? So if they would take, means the court officials would decide to take Gandhiji in the court, then what? Gandhi asked, why? The senior lawyer replied, they had come to advise and help him. If he went to jail, there would be nobody to advise and they would go home. So here, if there is no dialogue, if there is no communication, if there is no backup plan, then once they will take the Gandhiji in that custody, then again no one is there to lead. And now awareness created, pigeons are there. But if leader is inside, then again there will be problem. So here, what about the injustice to the sharecroppers? Gandhi demanded the lawyers withdraw. Here withdrew to consult. Rajendra Prasad had recorded the upshot of their consultation. They thought amongst themselves that Gandhi was totally a stranger. So now there was a discussion that Gandhiji was totally the stranger for them and in that area. He was not a native from that area. And yet he was preferred to go to prison for the sake of peasant. But till he is preferred to go in the prison, in the jail, because of the peasant, because he was leading the peasant. If they, on the other hand, being not only resident of adjoining district, but also those who claim to have served these peasants, should go home, it would be shameful desertion. So here, it would be shameful otherwise. If we are going home, if we are not supporting Mahatma Gandhi at that time, and we are the native and we are serving them, so here all that cases, it is with us. So it would not be fair to go back, and it was their introspection. And this is the very important thing here. We can accordingly went back to Gandhi and told him they would ready to follow him into jail. And now what is the fact? That very important here announcement, that is they told him, Mr. Gandhiji, they were ready to follow him into jail. If he would be there in the jail, then also they will follow Mahatma Gandhi. And this is what the important factor, that when educated people would join such type of mission campaign, then it is not only one person's leading campaign, that it is the now united campaign of the group of the educated people. If they are leading some campaign, then that campaign will surely successful. So here, then what is the statement? Gandhiji's statement, "The battle of Champaran is won," he exclaimed. And why the battle of Champaran is won? Because now there is no need of me, because you are also a lawyer and you have also that skills to lead. So if you have taken that responsibility, then the battle, it is won. So the battle of Champaranya, it is won. Means now you are leading and you are ready to follow me also. So nothing, it is now the problem. I am not thinking about any failure now. So whenever we are thinking in positive way, when there is a support from the educated people, there would not be any failure you can observe. Then he took a piece of paper and divided the group into pairs and put down the order in which each pair was to quote arrest. So here, now they had a discussion and the plan, now plan is ready how to go ahead. Then afterwards, what happened? Several days later, Gandhi received a written communication from magistrate informing him that the lieutenant governor of the province had ordered the case to be dropped, and whatever that charges, whatever the disobedience issue it was raised against, or the summon it was issued against the Mahatma Gandhi, that case is dropped. And one important thing here, the civil disobedience, to disobey the law, disobey the order of that police superintendent, it is civil disobedience. So civil disobedience attempted means here the victory, civil disobedience attempted the first time in modern India. And that was the first example in that modern India, that if somebody would do the civil disobedience and the magistrate would declare or drop that case. So here, this is the very important thing we can observe through this example, that civil disobedience, such type of issues, if somebody would do, if common person or the person who is not with the plan, if he would do such type of things, then we can understand that that person may not succeed. So what we learn from this example, that suppose you are going ahead with the plan, and if you will not have fear in your mind, and if you will take help of the friends, followers, and especially the common man like a peasant with you to fight against any kind of injustice, especially with the legal matter, then what will be the preference? The preference will be you will get the justice, and the officials will change their decisions, officials will change their proceedings. They will be in such a state of mind that we have to stop something, whatever they are doing, and the higher authorities will also interrupt, and they will also instruct them not to arrest that person, or they will also think that anything may happen, there would be problem of law and order in that case. So for today's session, we would conclude here. Up till this, you can understand, and this is the very nice phase that you are here. Why we are happy here? Because such type of important decisions, now we are understanding in the history it happened. So thank you. We will learn next part in the next video lecture.